Hello everyone, thank you for tuning in. I am playing Velvet Assassin. Got for $5 at GameStop just today. It's a Microsoft exclusive stealth video game. Alright. And I think it's not bad. If you like Splinter Cell, it's very similar when it comes to gameplay. So what I'm gonna do, I just died. And I was like, you know what, let's record some of my gameplay, because it's actually kind of interesting, it's kind of funny, alright? It's a stealth game, and it's like, oh man, where'd he come from and stuff. Okay, last checkpoint. Can you guys even see the screen? Alright, let's go. So similar to Splinter Cell, it's about light and dark and stuff like that. You see how she's glowing blue? So she glows blue when she's completely dark. You can't see her. So we're gonna sneak around these guys. Let's get him. And hide the body. Okay. So the game is, you're in World War II. These are all flashbacks of her missions. And apparently it's based on the true story on an actual female spy. A French female spy. So, okay. I think we got one more enemy in this area. Watch out for the water right there. There we go. Got it. By the way, this is the, this is like mission 4 or something. And you can get experience by doing collectibles. Alright. So there's all my stats so far. I've only upgraded my stealth powers or whatever you want to call it. So this is mission 4, okay. See? Mission 3 out of 12 missions so far. Okay, let's go back. A collectible. Yeah, time to upgrade character. Morphine is like your, like in Metal Gear Solid 5, you have that reflex mode. It's kind of like that, right? Increased speed of sneaking. Strength, increase the number of hits you can take. If you're being very stealthy, you don't need to worry about that, huh? Let's increase stealth again. Okay. Med kit, we don't need that. What's in here? Ooh, a shotgun. Collectible. Tons of collectibles in this game. A lot of replayability. Uh-oh, what's going on here? Some dude on the right there. Oh, there's two dudes. Like a filthy swine. That's all right then. You're speaking German. So I'm guessing I was captured. And now I'm seeing like how it happened. Like the whole game's a flashback. Okay, let's move on. something sparkling. Ooh, I got an achievement. Attentiveness. That's what it's called, attentiveness. Ugh. Let's see what it's about. Got 7 out of 45 so far. Attentiveness. You have secured 15 collectibles during the campaign. Okay. Okay. Let's keep playing. Another dude somewhere. Where'd he go? There he is. Look, I got another trophy. An achievement. Assertiveness. What does that mean? Velvet Assassin. Okay. You have killed 50 enemies during the campaign. Okay. It's just for killing 50 enemies. Shotgun shells? Yes. We did it! Come on, focus! Yeah!
After the Majestic,
E-day.
Peace returned to Paris.
Peace returned to Paris. Yes, another one. Liberator. I bet it's just for beating the game. Beating the mission. There it is. 15 out of 22 kills. I've only found half of the collectibles. These missions take too long, man. The last mission, the one before this one, which I did not record, took like a whole hour. Okay, let's move on with the game. Is that it? Aha. Yep, there it is. Witness, 10 gamer score. That was one of the shorter missions. Look, I got the best rating, Assassin. Okay. Onward. Come on, come on, come on! Uh-oh. Enemy sniper. Oh, no! Oh, man. Wasn't a headshot, though. It was a shoulder wound. Wow. Assault. That's the name of this achievement here. 10 Gamer School. Look, rating, agent. And as usual, an hour-long mission. I'm getting a lot of fun out of this game, man. Hours of entertainment, for sure. Oh yeah! Phoenix. I see some stuff in here that's going on.
Won't be sticking any more.
Oh wow, look, I got an achievement. Avenger. What does that mean? I got an achievement out of the blue. Don't know, I wasn't even going for this one. You have killed the drunken submarine captains. Okay. Pick up a collectible. Oh, I have enough to upgrade myself. Increase strength. Okay. Let's just move on. Close. Yep, I got it. In the lion's den. Awesome. Oh my gosh. These missions are way too long, man. So look at that. An hour and a half just to beat one mission. Looks like I did pretty good. One more collectible, though. That's unfortunate. Okay, onward with the game. We did it. 1 hour and 28 minutes. Holy crap. Ooh. Where do we go?
The submarines were destroyed. Operation Morale was a complete success.
Awesome.
Later, I heard that 30,000 civilians were also killed.
Oh, man. Yep, got it. There it is. Firebug. I can't believe this mission took an hour and a half to beat. Look at that. That is ridiculous. It should not... No game should take like an hour and a half to beat like one mission. On the easiest difficulty. Jeez Louise. Alright, let's move on with the game. Golly. Alright. Whew. Yeah. Yep, there it is. Down and dirty. Took me an hour to finish this mission. Got half of the collectibles. Need to go back and get some of that. Okay. Alright guys, here's the lowdown. I didn't record the original time I played it. I already beaten the game already, I just reloaded the checkpoint and played the game again. Alright? I played the final segment. So this is the cutscene right here. It's kind of depressing. Our main character dies. So that explains why there are no sequels for this game, because I think this game's great. Velvet Assassin. I really enjoyed it. So there's many other parts from other stealth games. There she is. Oh my gosh. So sad. There's a lot of other elements from other stealth games that you see. There it is. Oh my gosh, rating is rookie. Kills 40 out of 49. Silent kills 4 out of 40. I only found one collectible. I have no idea where the other ones are. No clue. But I kind of run and gun through the final segment here. Here are the credits. So as I was saying, this game has very other similarities to other stealth games, like Hitman, Splinter Cell, Tenchu, Metal Gear Solid. You know, the goal of the game is to sneak by all the enemies, stay in the shadows, you know. Meanwhile, you have, you know, collectibles, you have your objectives, you need to kill this person, you need to talk to this dude, find this particular item, you know. And, you know, similar to Hitman, you can change your clothes and sneak among the people. Like, you can actually dress up as a female soldier, a female Nazi. And then you can sneak by all the enemies. Similar to Hitman, you know, you can dress up as the enemies or whatever and sneak by them. You have to stay in the shadows, kind of like Splinter Cell. There's colors, like she will glow blue or purple or whatever. It looks blue to me. But she'll glow, there's an aura around her, every time you're in the shadows. So you know the enemies can't see you if you're glowing blue. There's also morphine mode, which is pretty similar to reflex mode in Metal Gear Solid 5. Everything just slows down, and it gives you a bullet time or whatever, and then you can react quickly. Lots of elements that you see in other stealth games. Not a lot of weapons in the game. You're very low on ammo until the last mission. Last mission, you're like the Terminator. You can upgrade your stats. How many morphines you can hold. You can run faster, sneak faster around. How many bullets you can take. Yeah, I like it. I like World War II games. I like games where you're killing Nazis, you know. It's a good story, kind of. You see, I mean, the story unfolds through flashbacks. I enjoy it. Here, let me show you all the achievements I got for this game. 24,620 so far. Velvet Assassin, 26 out of 45 achievements. I have secured 40 collectibles during the campaign. There it is. You have completed the campaign in normal difficulty. Completed a mission without getting identified. And then every mission you beat gets you another another achievement. Kill 100 enemies silently during the campaign. Found all the letters. There's a lot of collectibles in the campaign. Kill 150 enemies. A lot of these you didn't get to see. They just kind of popped that out of nowhere. I was like, whoa. You have earned your first skill point. Yeah. Lots of achievements in one game. So I got this game for $5. I think it's worth the money, man. Here, let me see. I think you can actually see. Load game. You can actually see how long it takes for each of the... 8 hours. It's, well, this is... Yeah, I think this is the last one. This is my most recent save point. It's an 8.5 hour game. Pretty good length, alright? And the game is $5 at GameStop. So I think that's worth the money. So if you like stealth games, and you want a recommendation from me, this one's good. It's tough, by the way. It's really hard. But once you beat a mission, it's very rewarding. Alright? I think the most annoying thing about the game is that the checkpoints are very far and few between. So you have to repeat a lot of times. I bet you can finish this game in like 4 or 5 hours. But 8.5 hours for me, just because I have to repeat a bunch of times. I keep dying and stuff. I like it, man. Alright, thank you for watching. Rate, comment, favorite, and subscribe. I'll talk guys later. Bye.